first tonight, a story that's bound to embarrass state MPs and the government in particular.
Just as Barry O'Farrell slashes billions from education funding and elsewhere and sacks thousands of public servants, we found out today that millions could soon be spent sprucing up the Parliament building. Josh Murphy is there tonight, and Josh, this isn't going to go down well with too many people, is it?
Well, Bill, here where I am behind Parliament is the exact same spot where thousands of people have protested over major cuts to education spending and cutbacks in the public service. They won't be happy to hear that the building they've marched on is now getting an extension. A new office block will be added at a cost of $5.5 million. Tonight, we can show you the plans and the fallout and how much it's going to all cost. Number 6 Macquarie Street, Parliament House. According to the government, it's now a full house. Another level will be added on top of the existing building, and here are the plans. It's currently a courtyard next to the rooftop garden to become a modern new block of offices. Unseen from street level, the $5 million plus project will house up to 46 staff responsible for parliamentary committees. A slap in the face, according to the opposition, with billions cut from the state's education budget.
When schools can't even get new fences, they can't get toilets upgraded, is an enormous insult to the parents of New South Wales.
The expansion plans are currently before Sydney Council. Both the Speaker, Shelley Hancock, and Upper House President Don Harwin weren't available to comment. But at a trade union rally against O'Farrell government cutbacks, a Federal Labor frontbencher also condemned the project.
When you're doing all sorts of things which are cutting services to the citizens of New South Wales, I think the priorities are the wrong way around. Put people first. Buildings, carpets and curtains second.
The building is intended to accommodate staff close to Parliament, replacing two leases in other nearby buildings, but others aren't convinced it's necessary.
We will make it very clear that we are not happy with the decision to extend.
This project comes after another $5 million program last year, which saw bomb-resistant glass installed to protect MPs from potential terror attacks.
Now, the government argues that by moving two leases out of other buildings nearby and moving them here to a new building will ultimately save money. And we were told this afternoon that construction, once all approvals have been granted, should begin immediately with a view to completion in 2015. Bill and Sandra.
Josh Murphy with that exclusive report.